Him?
Yeah. I know him. It's going to take a while. It happened years ago. Did you know there are three kind of aces? Those who seek strength, those who live for pride, and those who can read the tide of battle. Those are the three. And him?
He was a fighter pilot they called Solo Wing Pixie. This man was his buddy.
You know, buddy, just look at the view. There's not much difference between those countries from up here.
He is the man I seek.
It was a cold and snowy day.
Who is the victim, and who is the aggressor? And what is peace?
Falcon fighters approaching. Shoot them down and secure your superiority. They've got a Kratos at the door. Time to hunt some wild dogs. These are round table fighters. Stay sharp.
The round table's nothing special. I'll take care of things.
Oh, him? Yeah. I know him. It's going to take a while. It happened years ago. Did you know there are three kind of aces? Those who seek strength, those who live for pride, and those who can read the tide of battle. Those are the three. And him? He was a true ace.
He was a fighter pilot they called Solo Wing Pixie. He was a colleague of the man I seek. 10 years ago, there was a war that engulfed the world. The Belkan War. And in that war was a pilot who trailed across the sky and disappeared from history. He was a lone mercenary who inspired both fear and admiration. He is the man I seek. And so, with the words of Solo Wing, the curtain rises.
It was a cold and snowy day.
Listen up. We have a situation on our hands. A major squadron of Belkan bombers has crossed our border, and it's making its way here, to Valet Air Base. Apparently, they intend to attack our base in an initiative to gain hegemony over the entire Republic of Ustio. Valet Air Base is our country's last line of defense. If our base falls, no one will be left to stop Belkan from taking over Ustio. Your mission is to destroy the squad of bombers and defend our base. Belkan's invasion must end here.
you boys managed to get up. Gulf 1, Gulf 2, maintain present course.
This is Gulf 2, roger that.
Bearing 315, Vulcan bombers approaching.
Nobody wants to bail out into a mound of ice. We're counting on you, flight leader. All units prepare to intercept.
You gotta have our pay ready and waiting.
That's only if we both make it through this alive.
Be ready to pay up. We'll be back before you know it.
It all started on that snowy day. My first impression was, he had potential.
Thanks to you, Belka's attack on Valet Air Base has failed. Your efforts will not go unrewarded. Your actions may well decide who wins the Belkan War. I, for one, will be counting on you.
The Belkan War is shrouded in mystery. But now, a decade after the peace accords, a portion of the records was finally released. I quickly got a hold of it. Wanting more details, I acquired information from unknown sources. There was a reason for my obsession. The roots of the war lie in the Belkan Federal Law Review that took place in 1988. Belka, suffering from economic strife, permitted its eastern territory to secede, and the Republic of Ustio was born. But Belka's economic troubles did not subside. Meanwhile, taking advantage of the situation, the world superpower Osea continued to flourish. Amidst the economic panic, an extreme right-wing party took power within Belka, aiming to restore strength and stability to the nation. And on March 25th, 1995, with the discovery of natural resources in Ustio, Belka began to invade its neighbors. It was the beginning of the Belkan War. Unprepared, each country fell quickly before the might of the legendary Belkan Air Force. In just a few days, they occupied all territories except for the mountain range. In response, the occupied Ustio government military placed all their hopes on a joint operation between Osea and the foreign mercenary forces. This, of course, can be found in any history book. But I noticed a strange similarity in the materials I gathered. There were several accounts about a mercenary, all followed by the code word, demon. But most of the information was incomplete. Still, I was intrigued. I decided to pursue the history of the Belkan War through this mercenary. I was certain I would find something there. Would it be the hidden truth behind the war? Or just another battlefield legend? I wasn't able to meet the mercenary himself. Actually, it's questionable if he ever did exist. But thanks to some old friends in the military, I was able to track down several individuals who knew him. Soloing is one such man.
Gain control over Route 171, which runs through Arlen, to secure a transit route for our ground troops. There are bridges along this route, three over the Ara River, all heavily guarded by the Belkan Armored Corps. Securing this route is critical to Ustio's attack on the Belkan forces. Destroy the Belkan ground units blocking passage along this route, and secure the supply line between our forces and the Ocean Army.
1, you are cleared for takeoff.
looks like luck was on your side again today, Solo Wing.
Mission was a success. Passage along Route 171 has been secured. Thanks to you, Ustio will now be able to launch a counterattack. Head Operations has issued an emergency order for a reconnaissance mission to be conducted near the border. You will be monitoring the airspace B7R, currently under Belkan control. Strong opposition is expected by enemy squadrons, and the presence of a magnetic field has been detected, which may interfere with communications. In short, this will not be a walk in the park. The B7R airspace is located above an area rich in subterranean resources, where many conflicts have been fought in the past. You're authorized to engage enemy planes upon contact. The time has come for your skills to be tested.
Belkan Priority 1 Strategic Airspace B7R, aka the Round Table. It was the grand stage where we pilots performed. We were all on an equal footing, fighting under the same conditions. No affiliations or ranks to hinder us. Aces from every nation crisscrossed through those skies in pursuit of air superiority. The only rule of engagement was to survive.
Comm team, this is Eagle Eye. Penetrate B7R and get a feel for the surroundings.
Comm to Roger. This kind of job is what we're all about.
Enemies on radar. Exercise caution.
Thank you.
first kill.
That's all they are. No.
reinforcements confirmed down. Mission complete. Return to base. Incoming message from Allied Forces Operations Command. Allied Naval Force has begun its advance. We appreciate your work.
Looks like we were just a couple of decoys. Yo, buddy, you still alive?
Well done. I'll make sure Head Operations hears about how you defeated an elite squad of enemy Typhoons. Now go rest up. You've earned it. Ustio and Ocean Coalition forces are to launch a joint campaign. The collective strategic military force of the two armies will be referred to as the Allied Forces. The campaign will be called Offensive Campaign Number 4101. The objective of this operation is to secure a sea transit lane for the Allied Forces. To secure this channel, the Belkan forces occupying the Futuro Canal must be cleared out. You will be given a choice of missions in this joint operation. Offensive Campaign Number 4101 will be comprised of the following three air missions. First, there is Operation Gelnikos. This is an air-to-air surface operation, whose objective is to wipe out Belka's air squadron, port facilities, and surface weapons. Next is Operation Round Hammer. This is an air-to-surface operation, whose objective is to wipe out the Belkan fleet, its port facilities, and surface weapons. And the last mission is called Operation Koster. This is an escort mission, whose objective is to protect the naval vessels in Osea's Third Fleet, including its state-of-the-art aircraft carrier, which will be making a trial voyage. Fierce resistance by Belkan forces is expected in all three missions. Choose carefully which one you wish to participate in. That is all.
To Gom team, destroy all Belkan forces stationed in the port. Secure a route of passage for the Allied fleet.
I've made visual contact with Futuro Canal.
Damn it, a missile!
I can send our tanks into action at any time.
Guys, let me at him.
Enemy planes are on spot.
Dropping! Tank destroyed!
fighters. That eagle with a red wing, that's...
Bandits in gun range.
As a member of the Air Force, I'll defend this area with pride.
Locked on. Forces eliminated. Nice work, comm team. This should make your next operation a whole lot easier.
Mission success confirmed. Allied fleet, begin your advance.
This is Commander Weaker on the Kestrel. We appreciate the great air support.
Thanks to your accomplishments in Operation Gelnikos, campaign number 4101 was a success. The Futuro Canal will be a vital stronghold for the Allied forces. The mountain town of Solus Ortus is located just outside Ustio's capital, Directus. The Allied forces will deploy airborne troops, comprised primarily of Osea's 101st Airborne Division, over Solus Ortus, in a surprise air and ground attack on the Balkan forces. This operation will play a critical role in Ustio's liberation. Your mission is to provide support for the airborne troops. Destroy Belka's surface-to-air defense network and all interceptor aircraft, securing a safe drop zone for the airborne troops. Be aware of civilians still inside Solus Ortus. Your actions will determine their fate. Good luck.
Escort units, this is the 122nd Airborne. We're now entering the designated airspace. We can't return to base until we empty this transport. We're counting on you.
First, attack any anti-air troops positioned at our parachute unit's drop destination.
Get your asses in gear, people! You gotta jump or you're of no value to this unit! Anyone showing weakness will be left behind! Use that anger to get fired up and take them out! Understood? Go get them! Go, go, go! We're the best! We're the best!
gotta stay up here long enough for those troops to jump.
Operation Varsity succeeded. Ground troops are now en route to Solus Ortus. It won't be long now before Ustio is liberated. Preparations to liberate Directus are now complete. I will now brief you on the Ustio 6th Air Division's role in regaining control of the capital. Directus is divided into five administrative wards, centering on the River Crescere. Powerful weapons have been placed in each ward, comprising the Belkan Army's Ustio Ranch headquarters. This battle will determine our fate, as the annihilation of all enemy forces will mean liberation for the nation of Ustio. The enemy forces are primarily comprised of ground troops, but we have received information that, while not yet confirmed, there is also a squadron of high-tech enemy fighters.
Start the operation. Release five sectors under Belkan control.
Cypher, let's do this right. I know you've got what it takes.
Gum 1, engage. Locked on. Locked on.
It looks like all sectors have been liberated.
The city has fallen to the Allied forces. Any soldiers left, open up an escape route. We lost. The Falcon Army. We've been defeated. We got our city back!
They've got a reason to fight. This battle's over.
Warning! Warning! Enemy reinforcements approaching!
What? Now?
Two craft approaching at high speed.
Let's take care of them.
May 13th, 1995, Ustio was finally liberated. The tide of war was about to change dramatically.
Belka's Ustio branch headquarters has fallen. Directus has been liberated. I just received a vintage bottle of Chateau Bouloise for the Galm team. It's a hard-to-find Cabernet. Perfect.